I have two different versions of the same document. One I have edited, one someone else has edited. Now I want to compare. How do I do that? Well, many people actually erase the document side by side and scroll manually. Please don't do that. There is a direct, accurate, and instant way of doing that. Write within Word. Go to the Review tab, open the Compare drop-down and choose Compare. It'll ask you, where are those two documents? On one side, you open the original document. On the other side, you open the revised document. Revised means version 2 or input given by someone else on the original document. So to make it easier for you to understand, this is the original document. It has some topics, subtopics. Now I'm going to save this as the revised document and actually make changes in front of you. So I changed some formatting here. I have moved some paragraphs up and down. I also added a new sentence here. So you know exactly what changes have happened. Go to the Review tab, open the Compare drop-down and choose Compare. After you choose both the documents, it also allows you to put a name of the other party. For the revised document, I'm just going to manually type the word boss. Assume my boss has changed. Now click OK and instantly the documents are compared. Remember, we had not put any track changes. Still, retrospectively, it has incorporated track changes to visually show you what was added, what was deleted. And that is amazing. By the way, this is not a new feature. It is there for decades. Now let's look at what it is trying to show us. In the center, it is the merged version of the document. And on the left side, it is only giving you a list of changes which happened. And on the right side, there are two parts. The upper part is the original document. Lower part is the revised document. When you scroll any one of them, the other two scroll automatically as far as possible in synchronization. It looks very confusing first time you see it, but once you understand how it works, it's a really powerful thing to have. Now let's do it again. Why again? Because I'm going to go to that compare dialog, but this time I'm going to notice that button called more. Most of us psychologically ignore buttons like more and advanced because our brain is saying more means more trouble. Don't go there. But actually there is more benefit. You will be surprised as to how many things you can compare. What just happened earlier was it compared only the text portion. Sometimes the formatting is important. For example, it was a very formal document or a manuscript. Then every comma, every semicolon matters. The order of things matters. So maybe the content remained the same, but the paragraphs were moved up and down. So moves are also tracked. There are two specific options here which I want to highlight. One of them is the comparison is going to happen at word level, sentence, word, each word I mean. So word by word comparison or character by character comparison. And then it also has another option. Is it going to look at uppercase, lowercase changes also? But why would you want that? If it was a mathematical formula, upper lowercase matters. If it was code syntax, upper lowercase matters. And if it was a chemical formula, character level changes matter. So in very specific circumstances, word level comparison is not going to work. You desperately need character level comparison. So think about it and use it to your advantage. The next level, suppose I have one document, I'm editing it. I have sent the document to three people and all of them have edited the document. Now I have four copies. Now what do? I take my document, I take one person's document, combine them. Now I have a third document which is combined. I take that as the base, then take the second person's document and combine. So in pairs, you can still manage multiple versions of the document coming from multiple people. I know it is cumbersome, but then you asked for it because you send attachments. If you don't want this to happen, put the document on OneDrive, send a link to everyone, enable track changes, zero copy paste. We have a video for that already. Have a look. Have you noticed OneDrive creates versions automatically? Yes. So whenever there is a version, when you click on the version, it has show changes option. What is that? That is the compare option being used behind the scenes. In fact, it shows you next previous changes automatically. So even though you didn't notice this feature for 20 years, Microsoft has already incorporated it in OneDrive versioning feature. So start noticing it and start using it. And the last thing before you go, all this happened because we did not have track changes enabled. Now sometimes you have track changes enabled, but you still made the mistake of sending copies to people. So now I have 5 copies of the same document. Each one has track changes from different person, and I still want to merge them. Now that is also available in Word. That's called Combine, right next to Compare. But before you learn that, have a look at this video, which tells you everything about track changes, including combining documents, multiple track changes. So while we are talking about comparing documents, I'm sure you're comparing my content and my videos with other videos. If you find my content useful and valuable, why don't you subscribe to the channel and also share it with as many people as you can, because probably all your colleagues need this feature. If you have any feedback or queries, do post it in comments. That's it for now. See you next time. Take care.